Hello, welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I'm Harish Singareddy, a solutions architect at AWS. Today, we are going to talk about building and maintaining Amazon Machine Images, or AMIs. AMIs are templates that contain a software configuration. For example, an operating system, an application server, and applications. From an AMI, you launch an instance, which is a copy of the AMI running as a virtual server in the cloud. A common pattern is to set up a process to create golden AMIs through standardized configurations, like adding your own monitoring agents, consistent security patching, and hardening. But oftentimes, setting up the process is time-consuming, resource-intensive, and error-prone. EC2 Image Builder lets you simplify that using a one-stop shop to create an image management pipeline. Let's say you would like to build a base Linux AMI with some custom configuration and security tools installed. And once the image is built, you'd like to share it with other regions within the account or with other AWS accounts within your organization. Let's see how EC2 Image Builder can help you simplify and automate this process. The first step is to create an image recipe. Yes, as the name suggests, it's a document that defines the components to be applied to the source image to produce the AMI you wanted. Think of the components as the building blocks for that image. Image Builder out of the box also comes with a set of Amazon managed components for common packages and security standards such as STIG. It also comes with AWS provided test components that can be, for example, verify if images boot properly, requires drivers are installed, and if images are hardened to CIS standards. You can also create your custom components to install your packages, apply configurations, and run tests. Now that you have your recipe ready, let's take a look at the infrastructure configuration that is used to build the AMIs. Image Builder launches EC2 instances in your AWS account to customize images and run validation tests. You might need to customize this configuration to suit your needs. Maybe a bigger instance so that you can build components faster, or one of your components needs to download a package from S3 and you need an IAM role attached to the build instance. You can optionally create this infrastructure configuration within Image Builder. As part of the configuration, you can also define what should happen if the build fails and configure logs to be routed to an S3 bucket. Now, you have enough details to build an image. Let's see how you can share it with your application teams. Multi-account and multi-region setups are a very common pattern. You might be running applications in a region that's closer to your customers and using multiple different AWS accounts for production and non-production workloads. You can use Image Builder distribution configuration to define the additional regions to copy the image to. And with each region, you can also define other AWS accounts that can have launch permissions. And the final step would be to create an image pipeline that automates the build process. Image pipeline is the automation configuration that ties all of these pieces together. As part of the image pipeline, you first create build schedule. Build schedule lets you define the job schedule to run the pipeline automatically. A powerful feature of it is to run it only if there are dependency updates. For example, if there is a new version of the parent image or one of the components has an update. You can also choose to run the pipeline manually if you need to. And after the build schedule, you add the image recipe, the infrastructure configuration, and the distribution configuration that you've just created to the pipeline. That's it. You now have an image pipeline that runs at a schedule and builds your images to your specifications and shares it automatically. Check out the resources in the description below to learn more about EC2 Image Builder. And thanks for tuning in.